life and death. My son alerted me to the fact that there was the seagull that was laying in the rocks and that it was dead. And it meant so much for him to come and take a look at it. There is an innate yearning within all of us to understand life and death. And it's so easy for one to be afraid of death. We are most of the time, aware of it in the back of our minds, whether we're consciously or subconsciously aware of it. That there is this fundamental ending that approaches us all. And that with every breath, we're getting closer to the demise of the form of the body. And that there is something else waiting for us. And life and death are the keys to this world. For it is life that brings the consciousness and the awareness of transcendence. And death that brings the consciousness to the transcendence. And the transcendence becomes our path. For we will all have to transcend this form. And the fear of unknowing, the fear of the mystery, is something that seems to live within the heart of humans. This bizarre and almost irrational behavior of the consciousness and of the mind to create phantoms of fear that can haunt us and taunt us and take us from ourselves, put us into a state of consciousness where we feel unempowered because we're always afraid of the change, the death of a loved one, the death of the self, the death of an animal. I personally worry about the death of my dogs. Isn't that bizarre? I consider how many years I have left with my dogs. It's in the back of my mind, the thought that I will have to say goodbye to them. Hopefully, it will be at least 7 years more, but it might be less. And so, it's something that's always in the present of our consciousness. The awareness that my mother is getting older, that she will pass from this world, that I will pass, and the fear that something could happen to my little boy. I have a friend who lost his daughter some years back, and I was very close to her when she was little. I used to spend a lot of time with her. And she left this world as a teenager, which is one of the most heartbreaking things you can consider. And it has had quite an impact on me, if I'm going to be honest. Because I used to spend time with her, I used to teach her, I used to tell her tales. She was a gifted little girl, musically gifted. Rest in peace, beauty. And so, the impermanence of this world is something that's unavoidable. And that we're stuck in the fear of this impermanence, in the grip of this fear from time to time, is also unavoidable. Though, it is important for us to realize and understand that the fear is our own consciousness. We're afraid of the change. We're afraid of what we've become. We're all deep down afraid of whether we have moved towards a state of greater awareness, truth, knowledge, or whether we've become more asleep. Because as children, we're so infinitely awake. And as we grow up in life, we somehow lose some of that natural childlike joy, that natural childlike beauty. Somehow it escapes us. And I think this is the reason for the fear of death. Because when I was 3 years old and I drowned, and I came back to this world, the first thing that was apparent to me was that all the adults were living in a state of fear. They were afraid of dying, but they didn't know it. They were hiding from their fear, and that was why the world was the way the world is. And that the world would be so much happier and everybody would be so much more at peace with themselves if they could acknowledge the fact that they were afraid. And I used to speak to adults about this, and they used to become very concerned and afraid by me talking to them about this life and what is after this life. Because it was something they didn't understand. And that a 4-year-old or a 5-year-old could understand it, I think, made them feel uncomfortable. The only reason I could understand it was because I had stepped through it. I think that in life, the choices we make define us. And we've all made mistakes in our past. And on some level, we all want to correct all the mistakes that we've ever made before we leave this world. And I think that is the fundamental basis for the fear of death. I think it's because we know that we could have been better. We know that we can do better. We know that there's more for us to see. We know that there's more for us to understand. We understand as well that life is a perfect symmetry of causality. The cause and effect are the keystone to the way in which this universe works. And that we're answerable for every error that we've ever made on some level to ourselves, to nature, to life. And this is why I think we're afraid of death, because it leaves us naked. And we're afraid of the fact that we're going to forget, whether we know it or not, that when we leave this world, our memories get stripped from us, as the three layers of being get taken apart, like the unwinding of a spiral or a ball of wool, as we get larger and the world gets smaller, until the world becomes a little dot and we become infinitely larger than this universe. To exist in a state of consciousness which is beyond anything that we can imagine. True hyperdimensionality. So, what this means is that we need to learn to forgive ourselves, and to forgive each other. And we can only forgive ourselves when we truly forgive each other. For forgiveness, for give, is to allow the life force to flow through you unimpeded. And when the life force flows through us unimpeded, we're in a state of unity. And in that state of unity, there can be no fear of death. And it's because we deny the state of unity, we don't forgive ourselves, we don't forgive each other. We live trapped in the memories of our past and the fears of our futures because of this lack of forgiveness. There was a great teacher that came to teach us about forgiveness and just how profound it is to the nature of the heart in terms of the revelation of the soul, in terms of this life, impermanence, and the internal state of consciousness, which is the birthright of the human. The shaman understands this deeply and brings this to bear. For the shaman is aware that life is impermanent. And this is why the shaman places one's awareness within the sphere of nature. For nature is where this beautiful force of life comes from. It's the enrichment that the soul has been seeking. It's the beauty. It's fire. That golden spiral of mathematics which is always touching the heart. We live in these little cubical spaces with corners that cause us to feel unnatural in a world that's round, where there are no corners, where there are just shapes, shapes of beauty that reflect the sphere of life. And the sphere of life is the sphere of the shaman. For life is nature and nature is life. The word nature finds its roots in the meaning of life. In fact, that is the meaning of the word nature. It means living. And we forget that that is the root of the self, the root of the soul, the root of the heart. That life is an eternal principle that's flowing through us. So remember this anytime you feel afraid to try something new. Anytime you feel afraid of old age or afraid of dying or afraid of losing a loved one. Remind yourself that the state of consciousness flowing through you, which is love, which is nature, is an eternal state, and that nothing can ever hurt you. This is the Bush Whisperer, sharing the most beautiful sunrise ever seen from Water's Edge Beach, Cape Agulhas, southern tip of Africa, right next to the Penguin Sanctuary. Keep it real, keep it sweet, and face your fears to transcend. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti.